What is layered architecture of Autosar? Let's try to understand this topic in detail in our today's video. Hello everyone, welcome to Link Frequency and I'm Aishwarya Pattar. This video is part of our course that is Introduction to Autosar. So without any further delay, let's get started. So I hope my screen is visible now. Let us look into the first image that states there is an application software and a hardware. Here you can see both are interconnected. So, previously the software modules from different manufacturers could not be merged and installed on a single ECU because each firm had its own software architecture. Thus, a single supplier had to create the entire software for the ECU. In the image, you can see the software is completely dependent on the hardware. The dependency on both software and hardware was on higher side. Hence, for any small change in the hardware like the processor, the entire software must be altered in order to make the module functional. This could be time consuming and the effort of development was also on higher side. So, Autosar came into picture to resolve this issue. Let us see the next image wherein you can see the Autosar layer in between the application software and the hardware. So as on the screen, you can see the Autosar layer is in between. Here, the Autosar layer architecture makes the hardware and the software independent of each other. The top layer of the Autosar is independent from the underlying layer. So now the software need not have the complete details of the hardware. Hence, same software can be used with different hardware without altering the current working module's functionality. Moving on, let's see the layered architecture of Autosar. The Autosar architecture is based on three layered architecture module developed jointly by the stakeholders of the automotive industry, including the automobile manufacturers, the suppliers, and the tool developers. This is a layered architecture with three components, as you can see on the screen, that is the application layer, the runtime environment, and the basic software layer. Each layers have their own different responsibilities and functions. Let's try to look into each of them in detail. The first one is the application layer. The application layer is the topmost layer in the Autosar architecture. It includes various applications, specific software components that are designed to execute specific set of tasks as per the use case. It provides the application software that implements specific functions such as powertrain control, chassis control, and infotainment. Moving on to our middle layer, that is the RTE layer. The middle layer, that is the runtime environment layer, that handles the communication part between various components. The RTE layer is responsible for managing the timing and synchronization of different software components, as well as ensuring that they have access to the required resources and services. Last but not the least, the next layer or the bottommost layer is basic software layer. The final and lowermost layer of Autosar architecture is the basic software layer, popularly known as BSW layer. The BSW layer provides software components that are used across different automotive systems, such as communication stack, drivers, and libraries. Now let us move ahead and look into the specific BSW layer more detail. The BSW layer, as you can see, is divided into service layer, issue abstraction layer, and microcontroller abstraction layer. Firstly, let's start with the microcontroller abstraction layer. MCAL stands for microcontroller abstraction layer. It is a software layer in the Autosar architecture that provides an abstraction layer between the hardware and the rest of the software components in the system. It makes higher software layers independent of microcontroller. The purpose of MCAL is to provide a standardized interface for the hardware peripherals of the microcontrollers, such as ADC, PWM, and timers. This makes it easier to develop and maintain embedded softwares in the automotive industry. The MCAL layer provides the following functionalities. The first one is initialization and configuration of the hardware peripherals. The second one is low-level access to the hardware peripherals. The third one is interrupt handling. Last but not the least, basic error management. Moving on to the next middle layer, that is ECU abstraction layer. ECU abstraction layer is the software layer in the Autosar architecture that provides an abstraction layer between the ECU hardware and the rest of software component in the system. It makes higher software layers independent of ECU hardware layout It also contains drivers for external devices. It offers an API for access to peripherals and devices regardless of their location, such as like microcontroller internal or external, and their connection to the microcontroller. The purpose of ECU abstraction layer is to provide a standardized interface for the ECU hardware, which includes the microcontroller, sensors, actuators, communication interfaces, and other hardware. This allows the development of portable and scalable software for different ECU hardware platforms. The ECU abstraction layer provides the following functionalities. The first one is ECU initialization and configuration. The second one is access to ECU peripherals such as sensors, actuators, communication interface, etc. The third one is diagnostic and fault handling services. Last but not the least, low-level access to the hardware. Moving on to the next sub-layer, that is service layer. The service layer provides a set of standardized software services which allow the application software to interact with the underlying software components in a standardized way, regardless of the underlying hardware platform. The service layer offers the following functionality: memory services, diagnostic services like UDS, error handling, etc., ECU state management and mode management, operating system functionality, vehicle network communication and management services. This layer enables the application software to be developed independently from the underlying hardware and software architecture, which reduces the complexity of the software development process and facilitates the reuse of software components. The basic software can be subdivided into following as represented on the screen. The microcontroller abstraction layer is subdivided into four parts, as you can see on the screen. The first one is microcontroller driver, second one is memory driver, third one is communication driver, and last one is input-output driver. Let's know about each of them in detail. Firstly, input-output drivers. This module has drivers for accessing and using the input-output pins of MCU, including digital and analog PWM. The next one is communication drivers. This has drivers for ECU onboard like SPI, I2C and vehicle communication like CAN. The next one is memory drivers. It has drivers for on-chip memory devices like internal flash, internal EEPROM and memory mapped external memory devices like external flash. The next one is microcontroller drivers. It has drivers for internal peripherals like watchdog, clock unit, etc. and functions with direct microcontroller access like RAM test, code test, and so on. Then, next you can see there is a complex drivers. A complex driver is a module which implements non-standardized functionality within the basic software stack. It is highly dependent on microcontroller, ECU, and application. An example is to implement complex sensor evaluation and actuator control with a direct access to the microcontroller using specific interrupts or complex microcontroller peripherals. Example, fault monitoring drivers, core and peripheral self-test, microcontroller libraries, CRC drivers. Let's move on to the ECU abstraction layer. Here, you can see the subdivisions like onboard device abstraction, memory hardware abstraction, communication hardware abstraction, and input-output hardware abstraction. Firstly, let's look into the input-output hardware abstraction. It provides functionality for handling input and output to the system. You can see this is the block in the ECU abstraction layer which is directly linked to the RTE and also has access to the RTE directly, rather than going through the other system layers. Moving on to communication hardware abstraction. These interfaces abstract the drivers for specific communication technique. It provides the upper layer with transmission functions such as status information and send or receive functions. The next one is memory hardware abstraction. Abstracts the location of the memory device used. It provides the upper layer with functionality required to access memory via the MCAL drivers. The next one is onboard device abstraction. It provides abstraction from ECU-specific onboard devices. Moving on to the next, that is in the service layer. Service layer has like system services, memory services, and communication services. Firstly, let's look into the communication service. Communication services interface with the communication drivers in MCAL with the help of communication hardware abstraction. It provides the necessary functionality in order to run the vehicle network communication. This is achieved by providing an interface to the different vehicle techniques such as scan and flex-ray, along with the network management and diagnostics. This layer is responsible for communication between RTE and BSW layer for the protocols like CAN, LIN, FlexRay, etc. Moving on, the next one is memory service. It is responsible for managing all non-volatile data read-write from different memory drivers. This is MCU and ECU hardware independent. It also provides mechanisms for saving, loading, checksum protection and verification. Moving on to the next one, that is system service. It contains the Autosar OS, that is operating system, which handles scheduling and runtime resource protection. It also offers reasonable real-time performance. It can be used by modules of all layers. So, this was a short description for the Autosar layered architecture. Thank you so much for watching our video content. If there are any queries, you can surely comment down in the comment section. Until we meet on our next video, happy learning. Tune yourself to make a difference.